Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Might and Magic, the World of Xeen. As per usual, we are just going to jump on in here. Where we last left off, we had just finished talking to Korak. Oh, and they're throwing freaking copy protection at us at the very beginning of the video, because we saved, I think, in his tower. Or, apparently not, we saved in, Castleview, or... This isn't Castleview, How is Castleview? I'm an idiot, I thought it... Whatever. Alright, so I'm trying to remember. See, we had talked to Korak, we got the stuff from the chest. Okay, we're sitting on 200,000 gold, which I don't really particularly want to be carrying around with me. See, I do want to see if we can train. Yep.
Pretty good. Pretty good.
Yeah. Okay, so everybody is 19th level, except I think Chunk is sitting at 20. Because burglar bonuses or ninja bonuses, getting that extra XP from disarming traps and stuff. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and deposit 185,280. 5,000 gold should suffice, and I'm gonna go ahead and deposit 575 of our gems. So look at that, see, we're already at 750,000 gold pieces, and you know, we've only just begun the dark side, which is where we're gonna really start amassing large fortunes. Alright, so what time is it? It's actually in the evening, so I would be better off just sleeping. One more. Ah, blue nipples. Okay. 12 o'clock. Better. Okay, so we are essentially done here, I believe. I can show you guys the cloud roads, but we would just end up getting killed. So we're gonna head out of Castleview. Now, there is a lot. I always thought that Dark Side was a much more dense game than Cloud Side was. This is probably gonna take this. No. Alright, I wanna save. The overworld in Cloud Side, Dark Side was just much more dense with stuff. Hello, stranger, please come and visit me, Xanthus the Sorcerer. My tent is 25 west of Castle Blackfang. Yeah, I'm never gonna remember that. Ship is about to break apart under the current. Search? Well, yeah. You find some booty and slip off the ship in the nick of time. The ship sinks beneath the water behind you. 12,000 gold, 100 gems, and a bunch of stuff by the look of things. Oh, yeah. We've got some... Oh, all those dang boots. We might get to that this episode. And this is, I think, the draw cap mode.
There is a world.
Yep. By any chance?
Wrong.
Nope.
Go visit the monks of Castlewood for enlightenment and return to me when you feel you are ready.
Brother Reagan. Alright. Help, I'm being held captive in Castle Blackfang, Queen Kalindra, ruler of Darkside. Yeah, she's a vampire. These are, I think, yeah, manga melons. We actually need these. We need a couple of them, if I recall correctly. Get out of here. Freaking centipedes.
I am so glad you found this place. Without your help, I would be unable to return here to renew my magic and my youth. Because you have saved my life, I will use my magic to restore yours.
Alright. I think she just heals us.
It is good to
see. Oh, restores our magical energies. That's actually kind of helpful, I guess. Good to know. That is Felista, the unicorn whose alicorn we got in the very, 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 very beginning of the game. And these things are just of absolutely no threat. As I mentioned previously, this is like your newbie area right here for the people that started with Darkside. Take that. What do we have here? Wishing well. We'll toss a coin. 100 luck. That's only temporary though. And now if we go through those forests, we're gonna have to deal with like punji pits and stuff, and I don't want to do that right now. See, I want to go.
There is nothing in this world that I love more than manga melons. Unfortunately, the best, most sweet-tasting manga melons grow in the southern region of the Meadowlands, which happens to also be the home of the most vicious centipedes. Please help a poor monkey dog out and bring me some manga melons.
Yeah, I hate Nibbler, but we have to do this.
Well, it's about time. I practically starved
Okay, now, Nibbler's a dick. Because we're going to go to this dungeon, it's going to be locked, and we're going to come back and the thing's going to be like, I want another manga melon and I'll give you a key because I'm a dick. So that's what we're going to do. This is Sprite Forest. Yeah, and these things are all over the place, these troll holes. And if you don't have flying running, which I do, you end up falling into them, and in the majority of the case, get ambushed by trolls. Which, okay, I'm going to have to recast my buffs here. So that I don't fall into them. Because I don't want to fall into them. I think this is the temple right here.
What are you looking at? You don't even have the key.
Yeah. Okay, so we obviously can't go in there.
I am Sharla, first of the Sprites. We have a problem. The orcs have kidnapped one of our sisters. Can you help her?
So we get an RP choice here. We can help her, we can ask what we're gonna get, or this is a stick up, give us all your gold gems and energy discs. We will be good Samaritans and help.
Thank you so much. Go to the Temple of Bark and free her.
Okay, this is the Temple of Bark right here. And what they don't tell you is that the Temple of Bark is home to one of the most dangerous enemies in this game, actually.
He asked you for the key, didn't he?
Why can't we just kill Nibbler?
Thank you for the manga melon! Yum! Here's the key I promised you.
It's like an older version of Claptrap. I want to kill both of them equally. Okay. So we're going to try this. I don't know if we'll actually be able to do what we... like, everything we have to do in here, but we can try.
What are you looking at? Go on in.
Oh. Man, this control F4 and enter, like, on every loading screen is getting kind of old. Okay, I'm gonna save. Because, like I said, this place has the most dangerous enemy in the game. I'm not gonna say it's the most dangerous enemy in the game, because that's obviously not true. But the thing that's in here is nasty. The Book of Barkman. The fragment of text remains. It reads, "The Barkman will avenge, and only one who is not a disciple of Bark would ever feed the leaves of the tree in lieu of the roots of the tree. Barkman will know when the blasphemous act is committed, and he will come from the trunk of the tree to smite the wretched blasphemers in righteous wrath. Yea, unbelievers will fall before him like wheat before the scythe, and the glorious Barkman." Alright, so Barkman, I assume this is going to be a similar thing. Oh no! Ages passed before the time when men walked the earth, there was bark. From bark did all good things come. Bark roots drew water from the earth. Bark's leaves drew sustenance from the sun. Bark's branches held the sky above the ground, lest the sky fall and crush the world beneath it. One day, bark decided to walk about the earth, and so bark did. Bark carried the sky on his journeys across the earth, for there was no place for bark to rest the sky. Many years did bark wander the earth, and much did bark see. But there was no one to talk to, so Bark devised a fine plan to make people to talk to. Bark asked the sky to rain upon herself. Oh, and I just accidentally skipped there. Bark saw what Bark and the sky had made, and it was good. Now that Bark had men to speak to, Bark decided to rest where Bark was and speak to the humans for a while. Bark set down deep roots, and Bark spoke to the humans. Those humans who spoke to Bark the most became the disciples of Bark. The disciples to this day speak to Bark at the roots, which is where Bark keeps her ears. When at last no one is left speaking to Bark, Bark promises to walk again. Alright, so this is me killing myself. This is like the home of, like, you've got the Temple of Moo and the Temple of Ba and those in the various games. This is the Temple of Bark. It's like each one, each Might and Magic game has to have one. Now, if I recall correctly, there's some puzzly crap in here. A red potion. I think so. This should, in theory, be might. Let's find out here. Swell. Plus 5 might. Multiple drinks, huh? Really? I actually kind of want to shore up Chunk and Devon's a little bit there. Blue. What was blue? Blue is personality. So that is gold leaf all the way. Bark membership. Eh? Oh. John. It's like the frickin' credits right here. John Van Cunningham, Debbie Van Cunningham. There's priests. Yeah, troll testers, devotees, thousands and thousands. Ledger. Alright, so they've purchased magic skulls, spikes, bottles of ink, pages of paper, shovels, barrels, vials, and so on. Ow. These traps are doing more damage to me than the monsters are. Man, freaking Rove can one-shot the monsters. What does that say? I think... Book of Sap. I think Captain Planets put it best when he said that Rove is basically the poster child for mortality. That is definitely accurate. Book of Sap, Volume 2. Lever. You hear a rumbling in the distance. Alright, we are going to read these Books of Sap. I, however, want to avoid this spike trap, so we're going to do that. The sap of bark runs with power. Store the sap with care and add the holy bark of yak on the spring equinox to the sap to make it potent. The sap will make holy potions and improve health and character of the drinker. Okay, so those are the potions we got. Drink with care. The sap runs slowly, and the making of a holy potion is a slow process that cannot be hurried. The holy potions must be reserved for the disciples of bark, for bark requires her clerics to be strong of mind and limb. Okay. Only a fragment of the original text remains. Sap drawn from bark at different times of the year will make different kinds of holy potions. Red potions can be made only at the height of summer, for red is the potion of physical might, and bark is the mightiest during the summer. Green potions can only be created during the coldest days of winter, for green potions are potions of endurance, and while bark endures the winter, bark's sap runs with the power of her endurance. Yellow potions must be made during... and we don't know. Alright, well, so that's up here. So let's see what we've got down here. Oh, hey, more orcs! Free experience points. They're not spellcasters, so I'm pretty much unafraid of them. Alright, what we got here? A fountain. The augury heads don't know whether or not that I should drink from, so I'm not going to. Let's open the cage.
Thank you for saving me. I haven't seen the sun in days.
You're welcome, the sun and sky.
Thank you for rescuing me from these foul orcs. Remember, orcs can't jump.
Okay. Orcs can't jump. Ow. Or rumbling in the distance. It's probably doing something here, if I had to guess, maybe? Two more levers. Ow. I really need to stop, like, spinning, but I get moving and then I kinda, you know, just, yeah. I'm moving too fast, and by the time it's like, hey, guess what, you're gonna take some damage, I'm like, oh, I'm still moving. Alright, so the morning rituals. Take ye then the bark of the tree and sprinkle it with ash. The ash symbolizes the yak, the bark the moo. March ye the congregation in a circle about the tree, directing the half of them to chant yak and the other half moo. After three circuits of the tree, command the worshippers to sit where they are and clasp all the while continuing the holy yak and moo chant. Slowly and evenly increase the tempo and volume till every throat is shrieking yak and moo, yak and moo. Maintain the crescendo as long as the voices of the worshippers can hold it. Then, with a sudden motion, plant the holy bark of the tree, with the ash sprinkled upon it, into the ground next to all the other holy bark implantations. The implantation is the signal for the entire congregation to go silent. The morning ceremonies are complete. Break for breakfast, then repeat before lunch. Alright. I mean, it's kind of fascinating that, you know, they're, like, describing this whole religion, but I don't really, you know... I gotta say I don't care, but dang. I'm just gonna jump through all this. Can we actually go down? Yay! I think I hit those levers in the right order. I think that's what like the rumbling is. I may be wrong though. Oh, we got spellcasters in here, although it would appear that their effectuality is found wanting. Really? I mean, I can just teleport through the walls if I really want to. But they're, like, all just shifting. Seriously, guys, you're not doing anything. I think we're a bit beyond you. And, like, that's the thing is I never got, is, like, these are just, like, these are pretty plain Jane orcs. They got, like, I think, like, 20 hit points or something. Like, you could get in here with a low-level party and be able to kill these things, and then they've got the Barkman in here, which, you know, if you troll the Barkman, you know, you just die. Okay, we got another stairs. Can I teleport in here? Or is this teleport warded? Yeah, it's teleport warded. Alright. That's alright. Okay, so what do we have down here? Get out of here. Okay. So I'm gonna guess this area is supposed to be like a big tree or something. If I would have to guess. I'm just gonna murder everybody. Man, I am like, I'm going all crusades on the, like, Barkman congregation here. So we have here, Black Barrel, huh? I don't know that I necessarily want to open that, so we're just gonna leave it. Well, here, you know what? I can consult the heads. Yeah, they're both like, no, so I'm gonna go ahead and go with the heads and not open that.
The orc shaman tells lies, and his tea is poisonous. Watch yourself.
Okay. Good to know, I guess. Don't know if we're necessarily going to be parlaying with an orc shaman. Hello, email. Let's see here. What do we have on this side? More orcs. What a twist. More bodies for the grinder. Oh, hey, more orc shamans. Then, like, they even look bored. They're like, yup, we're orcs. And then I, like, punch them in the guts and they go down. Okay, nothing too interesting in here. Excuse me. Snuffly. Oh, dang it. Something just happened there. I think he just splashed us with tea or something. Which poisoned my entire party. Oh, these art guards, I think, are a little tougher. Orc elites. Alright. Well, I know how to deal with these guys. Overkill! Because that's what Starburst is for. Alright. Go ahead and detox everyone here, because I don't want everybody running around with their pukey faces on. There. Anybody else?
Thank you for freeing me. I will return now to my sisters and tell them of your heroic deed.
Yeah, I've killed quite a few of them on my way here, actually. Sorry.
The rest of the orcs imprisoned me for refusing to do evil. Thanks for getting me out of there.
Alright. Snog the orc. Alright. High Book of Bark. High Book of Bark Errata. Alright. Yea, and verily did Bark bring the flowers to her generous bosom and nurture them until they grew strong and prosperous. Bark spake unto them, go now, mighty flowers, and multiply and prosper. And the flowers went into the world and multiplied, and they did prosper as well. Bark saw that the multiplication of the flowers was good, but something was not 100% confidence, really. There is a weed in the garden, a black, ugly plant with roots as deep as the world and foul leaves that spread a shadow over the fair flowers and deprived them of the sun they needed to grow. The weed took water from the flower so that it may grow alone, and the flowers which grew under the shadow of the weed were stunted and twisted. Their roots were shallow, their leaves were not glossy. The weed began to tempt the other flowers with vile promises of water and sunlight if only they would serve the weed and help it grow larger than Bark and enclose Bark under the weed's black shadow. Many of the flowers bent to the weed's will, and the weed did prosper at the expense of Bark. Bark saw that this was ill and did seek to stop the weed's advance. Alright. The errata. Only a fragment of the original text remains. Page 8, paragraph 3, word 2 should be the instead of A. The astute reader will note that the marked difference of substitution of the article makes the text regarding the tending of the garden. Page 1034, paragraph 1, word 8 should be weed instead of weed. Even the simplest acolyte can tell that the weed source of all evil in the world should be capitalized to indicate that it is important to the world and to Bark. Page 8769, paragraph 2, word 7 should read. Wow. Alright, they're just kind of having fun with it now, I guess. Okay, so we've been there. I know there's stairs. Where are they? There they are. Okay, and I want to save. Okay. Oh, this freaking puzzle, I remember this. And I remember being frustrated by this. If I recall correctly, this puzzle has to do with because like I don't think we'll be able to go down. Yeah, Disciples of Bark only. It has to do with like the seasons and stuff. Just gonna go ahead and murder everyone here because that's what I do. Oh, is that a high priest maybe? Sha'alf. Shaded. Okay. Well, that was fruitless. Alright. So it's all the way outside. Yeah. Dial reads one. Alright, so all the dials read one. I'm gonna check my journal here really quick. Auto notes. Deep Mind Alpha. Dark Side of Xeen, Luck 100. Wow, that gives me nothing. Okay, pull the lever. Alright, so it made the farty sound at me, so it's obviously, you know, not correct in default here. Well, turn the dial. I'm gonna just kind of try and see if, like, if I turn them to face the cardinal directions that they're currently facing. Oh, Brook of Ascension, her! Let's see here. Set the western dials to 1, northern to 2, eastern to 3. Alright, so I'm gonna read that one more time, just to make sure I'm not being dumb here. Alright, so it's 1, 2, 3. Well, I was kind of on the right track, just starting point was wrong. Okay, so these guys stay 1. These guys go to 2. And these guys go to 3. And then it said drink of the water. Hold on. Okay. Now, let's see, I think that water fountain was back in here. Yes! You're hereby dubbed a disciple of Bark. Which, I can't tell if that's hurting us or not. No! Really? Wow, that's actually giving us a pretty substantial bonus to our hit points. Alright. Rose up to 247. Dang. His squishiness is vastly, vastly decreasing as we're gaining levels. I told you guys, I told you though, he wasn't going to stay like a complete pushover for the entire game. It's just the early part of the game where spellcasters are just incredibly wimpy. And Day of Sorcery. Excuse me, and a random hiccup there. Okay. A voice bellows, feed the roots and the tree shall bear fruit. Feed the limbs and suffer the wrath of Bark, man! And it's apparently going to bellow that at us every step we take here. Alright, so Barkman is in here. So let's feed the limbs and Barkman rage poops all over us. Well, naturally I'm going to feed the limbs because I want to see if I can kill the thing. Okay, so this is probably a limb right here then, huh? Also an energy disc. Well, how am I supposed to feed these things? The water is stagnant. Did that say something? Fruit rooms. Oh, okay. Do it. Feed the limbs and suffer the wrath of Bark Man. Alright. Oh, well, you know, I'm taking these energy discs. Another fruit room? Yes. Okay, well, in that case, maybe the limbs are up this way. I suppose that would make sense, huh? Treasure room. Feed me here. I think we have to feed all of them. So I'm gonna start. Well, I was gonna start here, but I need to see if there's another one. Yeah. I don't even remember what the fruit does. Like I said, I just want to find out if we can kill this thing. I would be incredibly surprised if we can. Book of Bark, is this just Lengthy diary of Barkman's life, only small portions still survive. Squeezed branch feeders today. Alright. It's all about the branch feeder squeezing, apparently. Barkman, I guess, likes squeezing things. Let's see. Only a fragment of the original immense text remains. Spread your limbs wide and plant your legs firmly in the ground and gaze into the hearts of the tree. Receive the wisdom of bark upon your head and sway with the wind and gather the sunlight into your skin, that you might know the ways of the trees and the grasses and all the green things under the sun. Yea, and verily, the truly faithful will dye their skin green so that they might better understand the life of glorious bark. Okay. You know, there's that whole cult thing, and then there's just a little bit silly, I think. Yes. Some gems. Oh man, this can't end poorly. Yeah. The life force of Barkman binds this chest shut. Alright. So, in theory, I think that's all of them. I think. Okay, come over here and check. No, Maliki's like right behind me or something. But, I don't think. Alright. So, I think Barkman should be free. Be able to check. No. Barkman. What you doing? Why you not coming out to play? I'm just gonna feed everything then. I really wanna try and stab you to death in the face. I'm not too particularly worried, cause like, if we get pasted, we get, you know, pasted, whatever. But if I recall correctly, I think he's worth like 1,000,000 experience points. And I really, really want 1,000,000 experience points, because who doesn't want 1,000,000 experience points in an RPG? Seriously. And I think the water will still be thick. Dang it! I keep accidentally hitting extra buttons. Okay. Cool, clear, and refreshing. Cool, clear, and refreshing. I don't know why it's not, like, raging at me. It should be raging at me, in theory. And I'm certain that I like, can't teleport here. For room. Unless I missed one or something. Which I suppose is likely. Or maybe I just need to feed one. There you go. Okay, so it's more than one gem, and I'm an idiot. Alright. I see your game now, game. We'll play along here. Okay, so there should be one more. Okay, now in theory, Barkman should be ready to come out and play now. Oh! Well, there's Barkman. Alright, Chunk. Wow, you can actually hit him. Alright. Well, I'm just going to... I stupidly didn't get freaking... I can't even remember the name of the spell that deals percentile... Oh, no, maybe... No, it's not time distortion. There's a spell that deals percentile amounts of hit point damage, and that makes stuff like this really easy, because he has, like, hundreds of thousands of hit points. At this point, it's actually going to be Gold Leaf that is more important to me than Rove. By pretty vast amounts, because Rove, his spell points are lacking. I mean, I'll try to keep him alive, because hey, why not? I didn't mean to melee attack with him there. Wow, Swell just went down. Let me think. So nail the lightning bolt. Bring Swell back up. Wow, Chunk, I think, just about bit it there. Considering how I just hit him with a power cure and it didn't bring him out of unconsciousness. Yeah, I don't think we've got this. I'm just gonna... Nope. And I guess that's where we're going to call the episode, because we are sitting at 30 minutes. Next time we are going to kill Barkman, I'm going to go back and we're going to get some percentile damage spells, and we are going to probably roll him a little bit easier than that. So until then, folks, take it easy, and I will catch you all next time. We're in Bark Fight 2015. Until then.